Welcome to Villa Santa. Take a moment to see the beauty.
How would I describe the Decameron?
Oh. 10 people, one luxurious villa.
And death is literally knocking at the door.
It's like a medieval love island. It descends into Lord of the Flies chaos.
You have this hierarchy, the nobles and the servants.
Luchisca has been a servant all her life. When the plague strikes, she has enough. She pretends to be a noble. She's like, we're gonna have a good time, because we're all gonna die.
Campanella, she's 28, so she's old. Leonardo is her last shot at love. She's like a toddler.
Tindaro is very wealthy, and without that, he's nothing.
Oh my God! Nefele and Pamphila, they're best friends, really.
It's kind of a perfect marriage, except...
they're both really horny.
I'm not lusty. I'm quite biased.
Philomena is bratty, entitled.
She wants to survive by any means necessary.
There is no way I'm turning this opportunity down.
I meet an eligible noble, he buys me a castle, I'm never alone again.
Cedisco is the head servant. He thinks people like him, but he's just a means to an end. Pampanea, I want to please her. She could be the head of the house. If she's the head of the house, she could keep me.
They're gonna kick us to the curb.
Well, I will gladly lick every inch of the boot that's wanting to kick me to the curb.
Nisia is at the brink of a breakdown. She'd do anything for Pampanea.
I will kill you in your sleep, and then I will kill myself.
No.
Nisia, you'll follow suit.
Yes, of course, right behind you.
Stratilia is brimming with knowledge about them and how it's all going to go disastrously wrong.
Dino, he's basically a medieval fuckboy.
Lovely wife you have.
That was every character.
Am I missing any?
If you can't get it right away, I get it.
What is happening?
It's a fight for power. Who gets to stay? Who gets to survive? Who gets to sleep with who?
It's a perfect recipe for madness. It's unlike anything I've seen on television.
Giving a lot of drama, a lot of sex, a lot of...
yeah, craziness.